Hello, in this video, I will explain a well-known algorithm that will allow you to program a robot to solve mazes with a wall-following behavior. So the aim of the presentation is to understand how to solve mazes using a wall-following algorithm and explain how this algorithm can be implemented using proximity sensors. One requirement for the maze is that it must be simple connected. That means that all walls need to be connected without isolates. So the idea is to use proximity sensors that will allow us to detect walls. In particular, we will use an ultrasound sensor to detect the walls in front of the robot and two lidar sensors to detect the walls on one of the sides of the robot. So the entrance and exit of the maze must be at the outer perimeter of the maze. So the algorithm for solving a maze has four possible stages. So, at least in the way I'm proposing this. So, the robot will change from one stage to another according to the conditions indicated here. So, these stages are also known as states where the robot is. So, actually, in the first state, the robot will perform the indicated action, which will, in this case, be following a wall. Okay? So in this situation, what it can happen is that you can follow the wall on the left or on the right. That's not the relevant condition here. But what it can happen is that you detect a wall in front, or you stop detecting the wall you were following. Okay. So in case of detecting a wall in the front, what you have to do is to make a turn 90 degrees, and then that's a pure rotation. Okay. And then once this is done, then you can go back to state one to follow the same wall, okay? But if it happens that you stop detecting the wall, and then in that situation, that means that you need to make a curve, trying to follow the wall or trying to detect the wall again as soon as possible, okay? And this is what is indicated with the make curve, in which the robot will rotate but at the same time move, okay, in order to move to a different cell. Finally, we can stop or the algorithm by detecting a mark, usually a line on the ground, that it's in, basically indicating that we have reached the exit of the maze, okay? So to learn more about how to solve a maze following a wall, please access to this indicated URL here. Okay, so to follow the wall, a wall in, on the right, we will use proximity sensors on the right side of the robot. We need two sensors, one in front and one on the rear. And that will allow us to estimate the angle and distance of the wall with respect to the robot. So guiding the robot to remain aligned with that wall at a given distance can be done with a simple kinematic control law. This is something similar we already saw, in which, in this case, K-wall is the gain to correct the distance deviations, and E is the distance to a dummy wheel to guide the robot, and this is known as off-center kinematic control. So, the distance at which the robot must stay from the wall can be known in advance if we know, obviously, the cell size. In the same way, we can consider the problem of following a wall on the left side, using the left side proximity sensors. But it's important to remark that if we decide to follow the wall on the right or either on the left, we should not change this decision during the maze solving, since we could return to the starting point. Okay? So therefore, this is something we must decide at the beginning, and if we decide to follow or to solve the maze following the right side wall, then we have to keep that decision. Okay. So, when following a wall, we might find a corner, like the one shown. And this can be easily detected with the ultrasonic sensor, in which basically, if we detect that the ultrasonic sensor distance is smaller than expected distance, then we have detected a wall, okay? And this distance, this expected distance, can be actually known in advance if we know the size of the cell and the thickness of the wall, in this case indicated with the letter tau, and the separation of the ultrasonic sensor with respect to the wheel basis indicated with a letter delta. So in case of detecting a wall, as I said before, we must make a turn of 90 degrees. That's a pure rotation, and this is something we can pre-compute in advance. So in theory, we cannot exactly the time we need to perform this turn if we know the wheel, the speed of the wheels. But actually, in the absence of an odometer system for low cost, which is the case for many low cost robots, we can just simply assume that we have measured an approximate time at a given speed that the robot needs in order to perform the turn. And whatever error we have in the end after completing this turn will be actually corrected with a wall following algorithm. Okay, so that's in principle not a major inconvenience. Another situation arises from the fact that while following a wall, this wall is not detected anymore. Okay, and usually the front sensor in this situation provides obviously a much larger distance than expected. So in this case, if the distance detected, I put the condition for both sensors. So if the distance is detected is close to the lateral distance that we expect within a certain tolerance, then we can say there's a wall. Okay. Either if one of the sensors does not detect a wall, then what we have to do is to make a turn of 90 degrees, as it will be shown. Okay. So in this case, again, the expected lateral distance depends on the size of the main cells and the wall thickness, but also on the lateral separation of the sensors with respect to the robot central line, as you can see here, indicated by the letter delta leader. So therefore, in case of detecting the no wall condition, we must make a curve, 90 degrees, trying to move to a top right or top left cell with respect to the robot orientation. And indeed, we can again compute or pre-compute the required angular velocities for the wheels using some straightforward kinematic relations. We can just basically also compute the time we need to perform this cure. And this will depend basically on the velocity we want to perform the cure, the some constructive parameters, but also on the cell size. Well, in this video, I have explained how to solve mazes using proximity sensors and a wall-following algorithm for a mobile robot. Thank you very much.